I designed and 3D printed this PTFE cutter with a measuring tool so I could cut short pieces of PTFE for my Prusa Mini, or if I want to do that Luke Hatfield trick on my Creality machines. But I wanted a two-color print so the numbers and lines are easier to see, and I want to do it on my Ender 3 V2 with AutoLevel. So let me show you how I did it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. Here's the original design. I created this in Tinkercad. It was pretty easy. Just a bunch of blocks, one cylinder down the center, and then the numbers. I 3D printed it at a 0.2 layer height. I could measure the PTFE tubing, cut it nicely, but my biggest issue was it was hard to read the numbers. I decided to redesign it into two pieces so I could do a two-color print. I've showed two-color prints using the Posit Height plugin for Cura and also the Z Offset plugin for Cura. But this time I'm going to use something that's already in Cura. It's called Remove Empty First Layers, and it's part of my profiles. You can check it or uncheck it. So let me show you how to use this to make a two-color print. I'm also going to do something a little different. I'm going to use my Ender 3 V2 with AutoLevel to do this print. To redesign it in Tinkercad was pretty easy. I just made a copy of the original. Then I took a whole block and made it 2.4 millimeters tall and another one that's lifted 2.4 millimeters. And then I brought it into the two designs, one on the right at the bottom, one on the left at the top. And when I group these together, I'm going to end up with a bottom piece that is 2.4 millimeters tall and a top piece that'll sit right on top of that. So here's the two pieces that I'm going to print, one after the other. The first step in Cura is to choose my Creality Ender 3 AutoLevel profile. This AutoLevel profile in machine settings has an M420S1 command, so it draws the AutoLevel information from EEPROM rather than going through and probing every time I go to print. So this will be helpful when I do the second print that this isn't going to run into the first print. The first part I'm going to print is the lower section of the base, and it drops into the middle of the bed. But I really don't want it there because even with drawing from EEPROM, it still homes at the center using the AutoLevel sensor. So it's small enough, I'm just going to move it forward and I'm going to put it to exactly 60 millimeters. That way I know how to line up the top piece when I'm ready to print that. I am going to use my CHEP 0.2 profile with a 0.2 layer height, 15% infill, and it does have the skirt enabled. I'll leave that alone. I sliced it. It's pretty quick. It says it's only going to take 44 minutes, but let's look at the preview. How well do these numbers look? And they look pretty good, so I'm happy with that. So let's print it. The first step is to run AutoLevel from the menu. Once I do this, it goes through a 3x3 probe, or 9 points, and then when it's done, I'll save that to EEPROM. So it says, do you want to save it to EEPROM? I click confirm, and now our AutoLevel is an EEPROM. I am going to put some glue down because there may be time between these two prints, and I don't want the bed to cool and the first print to pop off. The first print went down nice and smooth, the AutoLevel was good, so now let's focus on the top. I want to bring it in like this so it's floating and I can drop it right on top of the other model. So I need to go into preferences and make sure that ensure models are kept apart is unchecked and automatically drop models to the build plate is also unchecked. With the base still in the bed in Cura, I'm going to bring in the top section, which drops down in the middle. And I want to lift this up and move it forward. So I'm going to lift it up to 2.4 millimeters and it'll stay there because of those preference settings that I did in Cura. Now I'm going to set the Y to 60 millimeters, should drop right on top of the base, which it does. Now I can get rid of the base because I know everything's lined up. So just click on the base and delete it. Here's the piece floating in the air, so now we can slice this. I'm going to use the same profile, but I'm going to make two changes. I'm going to get rid of the skirt, and second, I'm going to search for empty first layers. Here it is, remove empty first layers. In my profile, it's checked, and let me show you what that does. So if I sliced it with that checked, it ignores those first layers and puts the print right down on the bed. So you uncheck it and it won't ignore that space and print it floating in the air, which is what we want for this print. Now because I started with the base print, it's showing that name, so I'm going to change it to top. So when I save it to the SD card, it saves as a separate file. So during that time, the first print printed beautifully. It's still stuck to the bed because of that glue. Now we can pull the white filament out and I'm going to use some red. This is protoposta candy apple red. And we're going to print this on top. So I run that file. It's allowed to home right on the bed because we moved the print forward. And now it's going to lift 2.4 millimeters and start printing the red, the top print, right on top of the white. And here it is all finished. That is definitely easier to read than a single color print. So now let's test it out. If I just want a clean cut on the end of a long PTFE tube, I can slide it all the way through, held at both ends, and make the cut. And if I slide it out and take a close look, you can see we have a nice straight cut. For shorter pieces, I put my blade in the slot where I want it, in this case 46 millimeters, and then go to the other end and cut it. And this should give me the length that I want. So how accurate is it? 46.2, 0.2 millimeters off, not too bad. So if I ever need to replace that PTFE tube in my Mini or on any of my machines running a Luke Hatfield fix, I can easily do it with this tool. I designed this to be 100 millimeters long, which is actually handy. Probably should have made 120, but I'll show you why. It printed out exactly 100 millimeters, so I can use this when I'm doing E-steps, so I can easily mark the filament before I run it. So if I made 120, it'd be perfect, but this still works. I can run 100 millimeters through and see if I'm accurate. I showed how to do that in a previous video. I'll put links to all three files in the description below, the single color print, and then the bottom and the top files to do a two color print, so you can try this on your 3D printer. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.